coaching session and start making the cut. Call or text 602-820-6978 or online at makingthecut.biz. That's 602-820-6978 or online at makingthecut.biz.
Too often, hardworking individuals who find themselves with legal issues are not sure where to turn to you to find counsel they need at prices they can afford. Lawyers for Less is created out of the desire to provide quality legal service to everyone who needs it, not just those who can afford it. Hiring Lawyers for Less does not mean less service, but just less money out of your pocket to receive the guidance and counsel you need. Our passion for the law means that no legal matter is too big or too small. If you're in a legal mess, don't stress. Call Lawyers for Less at 602-800-5762 or visit lawyers4less.com.
What if I told you that getting Medicare coverage doesn't have to be a complicated process? Are you tired of being confused with the many coverage options available to you with Medicare? At Tapestry Insurance Group, let us help by taking the confusion and complication out of your Medicare options so you can get the coverage you need. Some available plans have no additional premium and may help lower your out-of-pocket costs.
There's never a cost for a consultation with our licensed agents, so don't delay. Contact us at 602-541-7656 or visit tapestryinsurancegroup.com.
Frequent trips to the bathroom keeping you up at night? Sudden urges or leaking when you cough or sneeze, interfering with your quality of life? Then Bijou Med Spa is your answer. All treatments are non-invasive without drugs or surgery and FDA approved. Approved by Medicare too. Our treatment is also incredibly affordable and convenient. With four locations in Mesa Surprise and Scottsdale. Schedule your free consultation at stopthep.com or call 480-593-5400 for the relief you've been looking for. Let Bijou make you a better you. If I traded it all,
if I gave it all. So welcome back, everyone. We're live on Facebook. Hi to everybody out there. I'm going to go ahead with my next tip. We've got a lot of them in here today. I have with me Dr. Reihman, and he's a practicing physician at Desert Center for Allergy and Chest Diseases. Welcome to the show. What a perfect time for this to do. Everyone's sneezing and popping and hacking it all up out there. Tell us a little bit about yourself, right?
The practice and what they do there. Go ahead.
Carol, I sure appreciate the opportunity to be here with you today. I practice pulmonary medicine and sleep medicine with the Desert Center Allergy and Chest Medicine, which is in North Scottsdale. Our practice consists of a group of providers, specialists, board certified in pulmonary disease and allergy, immunology, sleep medicine. Practice have been in the Valley for over 20 years, and I think we do a good job. And I appreciate the opportunity today to discuss my practice in sleep medicine with you.
Well, first I want one of the things that we're going to differentiate here. So what makes your practice unique?
I think that we are especially good at being responsive and quickly getting patients into our office. You know, there are so many excellent physicians out there, but so often their practices are just overwhelmed. They do a good job and they have difficulty getting patients in or sick patients. I think we do an excellent job of getting in patients in quickly. You know, they're concerned about their medical issues. They're anxious to be evaluated. And I think we do a great job in terms of getting people into our practice and getting them evaluated and treated in a prompt fashion. And of course, I think we give, again, we're all certified in what we do, doing it for a lot of years. I think we give top-notch, first-rate medical care.
So how did a pulmonary lung doctor become a specialist in sleep medicine?
Yeah, that's interesting. About 50 years ago, people began to recognize that there was a group of people out there, oftentimes overweight, loud snorers, who had breathing trouble when they slept. And as they were studied, they found that at nighttime, they had what's called sleep apnea. Apnea means you stop breathing when you sleep. So in studying those patients, these pulmonary physicians began to then develop interest in sleep medicine, began to monitor sleep at night, and over a period of time gradually came to adopt a separate specialty of sleep medicine. So about 20 years now, there's been an American Board of Internal Medicine specialty in sleep medicine, just as there is in pulmonary medicine or cardiology, and I'm certified in that also, along with the pulmonary disease, which I've done for many, many years.
Okay, so first of all, I want to get out some information about you guys. You're on Facebook, okay? Here's really important. When you call them, you don't need a doctor's recommendation. I want to get that out with everybody because a lot of people think that sometimes, so I want to make sure you understand that. They're located in North Scottsdale. Their website is desertcenter.org. Make sure you go to .org. And their phone number, write this number down, 602-788-7200. 1-1. Now, this is how I'm going to make you be a little bit more comfortable and me more comfortable from this day today. I want to ask you, how old the patients are that you see? Are they young, or are they all sorts of ages?
Yeah, that's a good question, too. You know, our allergists will see very young children, infants. Our pulmonary physicians tend to see individuals above the age of 18. We're certified in adult pulmonary medicine. But our allergists will see individuals from birth to old age.
But people think that sleep problems, apnea, let's say, are for older people. Is that true?
It's more common in older individuals, but not really true. I've seen individuals. You know, there's a strong association between sleep apnea and obesity, and unfortunately, we have this epidemic of obesity, not just in older people, but, you know, in younger people too. So, you know, I see relatively young people have that problem and other sleep disorders also.
So what is the most common sleep problem in which you see?
Well, I see some patients with narcolepsy and restless legs and insomnia, but by far the most common problem in my practice is sleep apnea. I really appreciate the opportunity to discuss that today because it's really unrecognized. Many, many people out there, it's felt like 10 or 11% of individuals who have sleep apnea are actually diagnosed. So there's a huge reservoir of people out there who don't feel well, they're tired all the time, don't get a good night's sleep, perhaps they've developed hypertension or diabetes or even atrial fibrillation because they haven't treated sleep apnea. So it's a good opportunity for us to, this is a good opportunity for me to try to educate people out there that they have those issues. They need to see their doctor or be referred to our practice to consider evaluation for this problem.
So what are some of the common complaints that they have if they have it, and what are some of the signs that they might have it?
Well, you know, one of the common things I hear is, Doc, my wife can't sleep in the same bed anymore. I'm such a loud snorer. Or, Doc, I just have such trouble staying awake during the daytime. I'm tired all the time. I'm falling sleep. I've seen people drive their car side of the road because they couldn't stay awake during the day because they get such poor quality sleep from the sleep apnea. At night when they fall asleep, they stop breathing or they slow down. Their pulse goes up, their blood pressure goes up. They don't get that deep, that REM sleep that we all need. As a consequence, they wake up in the morning, they're restless sleepers, they've had a bad night's sleep, and they're very tired during the day. So all those things that are warning signs or signs that you should be consider evaluation for sleep apnea.
Nobody wants to sleep with somebody snoring. Nobody. And that, you know, that's why you should call and have a consultation, because there are answers for people, right? You know, and the only thing they're going to know is by if they call and have that consultation with you. Find out whether they have it first, right?
Absolutely, yeah. And, you know, we can talk a little bit, if you'd like to, a little bit about how we diagnose the sleep apnea. Yeah. You know, until a few years ago, the only way we diagnosed this problem was the patients would come to our sleep laboratory, usually at one of the hospitals around 9 o'clock at night. We'd be watching the light come the next morning. But these days, home sleep studies are sort of taken over the practice. We still do nighttime studies to hospitals. But the majority of individuals come to our office during the daytime. They pick up some relatively unobtrusive equipment. They put it on when they go to bed. They sleep in their own bed that night, bring it back the next day. We call them within a few days and tell them if they have a problem or not.
Now, why is sleep apnea harmful?
There's a high incidence in sleep apnea of concomitant hypertension, diabetes, atrial fibrillation, heart disease, all things that are very common day in American society. You know, as I think you're aware, there's an epidemic of obesity nationally, and that is a significant risk factor for sleep apnea. As a consequence of that, we're seeing high incidence of hypertension, diabetes, and also sleep apnea, too.
So they're located in North Scottsdale. They're also on Facebook. You could check them out there. Go on to their website. It's desertcenter.org. And you can also call them direct at 602-788-7211. You know, the best thing to do is to call and have a consultation. You don't need a doctor's recommendation. Really important to know that. Okay, so then obviously, what's a sleep study? They can either do it in your they do them at home, right?
Right.
That's
they
the
pick
best
up
way.
The equipment or office, take it home, wear it in bed that night, and drop it off the next day.
So what are available? Let's say you find out, okay, they have sleep apnea. What are some of the therapies that you offer?
Well, of course, we recommend things like weight reduction. But as far as media therapy goes, the most common therapy is what's called CPAP, which is inhaled positive airway pressure. The individual picks up a small air compressor device. It's a hose connected to a somewhat small mask where you tip it over your nose. And you wear it all night. And by the next morning, you'll have a better night's sleep. Wake up, you feel so much better. Don't snore anymore. More energy. And hopefully that stimulates you to not only lose weight, but also results in a reduction in your blood pressure, your pulse, your blood sugar, your cholesterol. All those are positive things I see people with sleep apnea. There's some alternative therapies we talk with people about. Oral surgeons can make what's called a dental appliance. Those are effective. And then there's which you've seen advertised on television, the Inspire system.
I was just going to ask you about that.
Yeah, that's got a lot of publicity. I'm not sure that the commercials are really accurate with that, though. That involves having a surgeon operating, make an incision in your upper chest. He installs a piece of device underneath your skin. He runs a wire to the nerve that goes to the back of your tongue, another wire to your breathing muscles. When you go to bed at night, you activate this thing. Now, it costs about $50,000. Of course, insurance will pay for that.
They don't talk about that.
Yeah, well, they don't talk about it. It tends not to work very well for people who have very bad sleep apnea. They're very strict in terms of criteria. You can't way too much to have this done. And you have to try CPAP first. CPAP always works, has no side effects. Not very many therapies in medicine always work, have no side effects. CPAP does. And we almost always start with that. And very effective the first time you use it.
Yeah, a lot of people do use them. But there are also, there's things that you can help them with for that they other therapies as well. Though, so when they come to you, what they're coming to you for is to find out, do they have it? Is that what that's the case? Or then to what happens once you find out that they do? Do you give them the therapies, or do you send them out for that?
Carol, that's a good question. Yeah. Now, we work with dental medical equipment companies, but we follow these patients. They pick up the equipment, they come back, they see us, we modify it. If they're having trouble with their CPAP, we'll change the mask. Now, we work very closely with these patients and ensure that they have a good response to the therapy, ensure that they're feeling, but ensure that they've been hopefully cured of this problem.
Sure, that's the main thing. That's what you want. You don't want to sleep with somebody snoring. So that phone number to call is 602-788-7211. You don't have to have a doctor's recommendation. They're located right here in North Scottsdale. Go up onto their website. It's desertcenter.org. The best thing, I think, when we're talking about all of this is, number one, people need to know that they put their heads in the sand a lot with a lot of different things, right? And if you're dealing with something, there's so many things that you can be, well, you may not be cured for it, but they can help you with it. Is that correct?
Absolutely. A patient has come back to me and say, Doc, I never know how bad I felt before. And, you know, there's different therapies, but a lot of patients with sleep apnea and take the CPAP. Doc, I can't sleep without that. I sleep so much better now that I've addressed this problem.
So, well, really quickly, how many hours are some people supposed to sleep a night?
Good question. Depends on age. I think that the average individual should get about 8 hours. Older individuals, a little bit less, perhaps. And young individuals, teenagers, young adults, really benefit from 8.5 hours.
Eight and a half hours. You heard it from the doc. Our number here to call him directly, it's 602-788-7211. The website is desertcenter.org. Make sure you put .org in there. They're located right in North Scottsdale. You don't need a doctor's recommendation. And stop sleeping with someone who's snoring.
It's nothing I planned, and not that I can, but you should be mine across that line. If I traded it all, if I could.
The information and opinions you hear on this radio show are those of the guests and callers and do not necessarily reflect the opinions of KFNX, its affiliates, management, or advertisers.
News, talk, sports. The Pulse of Arizona. 1100 KFNX, Phoenix.
This is CBS News on the Hour, sponsored by Staples.
I'm Monica Ricks in New York. The Supreme Court heard arguments today over President Biden's plan to forgive student loan debt for more than 40 million Americans. CBS's Nicole D'Antonio's on Capitol Hill.